Hi gents or ladies. Today I would like to introduce you to the envelope strategy. In fact, all strategies are built from the same elements. 1. Recognizing opportunities. To find an opportunity which usually has a knock-on effect. 2. Signal. It is easy to find one and there is plenty of way to do it. 3. Capital protection. Where to set stop loss. You must not trade without setting the stop loss. 4. Exit strategy. The Achilles heel of all strategies. 5. Trade protection. Move your stop loss to the break-even point. 6. Testing. Define your time frame and instruments. Reflect on the last 3-4 months. 7. Application. This is where most people fail. Be consistent and deliberate. Our strategy is based on the envelope indicator. Envelope means in our case a rather broad interpretation, because this indicator actually looks like a channel. The indicator is included in MetaTrader under Trends, by default. This is actually a moving average shifted up and down. Instead of using standard parameters, set the moving average method to exponential and use the apply price to median price. By this, the exponential method results in a more sensitive curve, tracking the price better. Median price calculates the average length of the candlesticks. After applying the filter indicator, our H4 chart looks like this. We can change the color to white for better visibility. As we can see, we have a channel that follows the price, where most of the movement is outside the channel. How we enter the market. We open a trade when a candlestick opens and closes outside the channel. The direction is obviously given. We must see how to avoid sideways trends, because they give us false signs for entry. As with any trend following strategy, this could be fatal. We try to eliminate this with a special filter indicator. The TMA line side filter indicator is not found in MetaTrader by default. This is how you set it up. After dragging it to the chart, you can see the following. The rules of the filter indicator are quite simple. The entry sign is only valid if the indicator color green for long trades and red for shorting the market. If the color of the indicator is yellow or neutral, then the entry signal is false and no trade should be opened. This method helps us to ignore false signals. The rules for entry are therefore as follows. A new candlestick opens and closes outside the envelope channel. So both the opening and the closure points of the candlestick are outside the channel. You should always wait for the candlestick to close, as the color of the filter indicator may change in the very last minute. It does not change after it's closed and keeps its color. The color of the filter indicator for the opening candlestick is green or red, for long or short. If there is a hole, or the color of the filter indicator is yellow, trading should be avoided. There is one more rule to follow. If the sign for entry is far away from our channel, stay away from trading. Let's see how to place the stop loss. The stop location, as with any strategy, is above the previous high with a spread with short, and with a spread below the previous low with long. Now let's see how to close the trade. Exit strategy. First, we use the Fibonacci tool to close the trade. There is a general phenomenon that, within a trend, there are corrections at 38.2, 50 and 61.8% Fibonacci levels, or at least the exchange rate stumbles. But that's not set in stone, it could be that only there's level 2 or just level 1 will work. Examine a trend. Open a chart randomly, look for a trend and apply the Fibonacci tool. Take a bigger time frame, H1 or H4. There is enough tick here to apply the general laws. The important FIBO levels are 32.8, 50 and the 61.8. You will see that something is always happening at these levels. They act as resistance or support levels. Not always appearing in group, but they clearly indicate important levels. If we know that there is a fallback at one of the FIBO levels, this will help us determine the profit target. When a correction occurs, there are three possible scenarios. 1. We are at 38.2% of the still unfinished trend. 2. We hold 50% of the still unfinished trend. 3. We are at 61.8% of the unfinished trend. Scenario 1. This is common when we have our first correction and the distance from entry is not too big regarding the pair's average volatility. In this case, if we apply the Fibonacci tool between the entry and the correction point, our target will be at FIBO level 261.8. This equals to 100% of the finished, completed trend. We can set our take profit to this level, but having the spread in mind, as the chart on which the tool is drawn, shows only the selling price. With long trades, set the take profit level plus the spread, whereas with short trades, it is the same minus the spread. Scenario 2. In this case, set your target price to 200% of FIBO applied between the entry and the correction point. This equals the 100% of the finished trend. Scenario 3. In this case, the profit target means 161.8 FIBO level. Use it as your profit target. This means that you have to decide which internal level is most likely to be reached after the correction. Obviously, at the first correction, let's say that we are at 38.2% of the finished trend. After the second correction, you can assume it is now level 50, and after the third correction or higher, it should be at level 61.8. With a little practice, you can learn this method and use it fairly reliably to set your profit target. Upon entry, let's look at where the trend started, whether there was a correction, and if so, determine the profit target based on the above. If you can't see a correction yet, open the trade without setting a take profit level. Wait for a correction to occur and then set the profit target. There are times when this method cannot be applied because levels cannot be clearly defined. In this case, we expect the filter indicator to change color. The short trade should be closed when the red line is interrupted, and the long one when the green line is interrupted. Same applies when either a hole is formed or the filter becomes yellow. In these cases, always close the trade, even if FIBO levels indicate otherwise. Now talk about the break-even technique. Halfway to the profit target, you can move the stop loss to the entry level. From this point, we can't lose. Worst case scenario, we leave the trade with zero profit. I would like to mention though, in my experience, moving stop loss to break-even point does more harm than good in the long run. Despite the aforementioned, I suggest using this method. Especially newbies still need small successes. A summary of the strategy can be seen in the following illustration. You can download the necessary indicators on https://www.forexacademypro.com. Good luck!